There is no perfect shape for a golfer, but we look at all of them and they've got to have proper muscle structure, no matter whether they're 5'6" or 6'6". They've got to understand the muscle structure. They're not always the perfect athlete, if you like. So there are some that have got more weight on than others, and some are slimmer than others. So shapes and sizes really are totally different, and you'll see that certainly in the Olympics here, different shapes and sizes. So, but more to understand how your muscles work is the key. So it's muscle structure rather than looking like Usain Bolt. Well, what you're looking for in golf is obviously perfect technique. So great mechanics, but that great mechanics come from muscle structure. So, you know, from your feet on the ground, understanding how your feet work through your legs, through your core, up into your upper body, up into your shoulders, and obviously then through to your arms. So it's complete muscle structure all the way up.
To have a strong core, just to be able to stretch it, generate, store the energy, and then unload it, of course, from the ground up, it is crucial as well. Golf is more a one-sided sport, so for injury prevention and lower back injuries, it is very, very important.
I relate the golf swing to a car. We've got an engine, we've got a steering, we've got a driver, and we've got fuel, basically. So in the golf swing, the body's the engine, your arm, hand, and club are the steering wheel, and your brain is the fuel and the driver. So we've got to get all those four component parts important. So your arm and your hand and your club are really the steering wheel of the golf swing. The posture is the most important thing. Your feet, approximately shoulder width apart. You bend from the hip bone, not from the pelvis, and then you allow your quads to relax in and let your arms hang naturally. So really we're trying to get people into a natural position, their own natural position.
Taking putting aside, which is the more quieter, I mean, you do want some actual hip disassociation and upper body disassociation on putting. You're kind of like just using the muscles on your back, the lats, just to guide the putter, trying to keep your hand quiet, kind of like we have a shape of a triangle and you ideally want that not to change throughout the motion, but that's the less physical aspect of golf. On the other hand, I mean, I can differentiate mainly between the finesse swing, which would be a short game and short wedges, and then the power swing. In the softer swing, anything inside 100 yards, you're trying to do a more controlled action, more based on rhythm and tempo. Still engaging the similar muscles you do with the power swing, because your swing tends to be very similar, but you are obviously not looking for that explosive energy at impact. You're looking more for a controlled, smooth action, so you are using those muscles in a different way, in a more precise and accurate way. And then you got the power swing, when you maybe take an extra wider stance, you push yourself a little bit more off the ground, and then you definitely unleash with your forearms at the very last minute to try to generate extra club head speed.
When they're practicing, even at tournaments today, we're at a tournament now, and you can see that these guys are hitting 500-600 balls a day, repetition, repetition, repetition. So it's a little bit like the gymnast that goes on the 4-inch bar and does a double somersault and lands perfectly on the feet. That's repetition, and what you've got to do is thousands and thousands of hours of that to make that look simple. It's not simple, and that's what these guys have got to do, thousands and thousands of hours, repetition, to make it look a little bit easier when they get out on the golf course.